Okay, so now that we've seen how we do it from close-up, we're going to actually have a look at all the possible permutations of these fingerings. So 1, 2, 3, 4 really only means the fingers. You can do it anywhere you want on the neck. So fret 5 is actually very good because it's kind of a comfortable position for your left hand and your arm. You know, sometimes people, depending on the guitar you have, the neck might be all the way out here, so the first fret might be a bit uncomfortable, so you can do it here. If you have small hands or maybe you're tired, you can do it all the way, you know, higher up on the neck, maybe on the 9th fret, from 9 to 12 or 7, you know, whatever works for you, 5 is a good place. So when you see on the table 1, 2, 3, 4, that's just the fingers, all right? So in this case, we'll have to be like 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, and as we said before, you find all kinds of combinations. There's 24 of them, and the focus of each group of 6 will be on a separate fingers. And what else should you know? Well, one thing you have to keep in mind is that you should be light on the strings. Okay, so when you play one combination, let's do 5, 7, 6, 8. As soon as I play one of the frets, I can just move on to the next one. All right, I don't try to hold the fingers down. I just do it like this. Okay, very light. And no rush, you know, do it very slow and just use it to warm up and to get to know your fingers and your hand.